So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to add a stream countdown timer to OBS Studio using StreamElements. So let's go ahead and dive into my money-making machine so we can get your countdown timer set up. All right, so here we are inside of my money-making machine, and the very first website that we're going to go to, it's going to be StreamElements, and I went ahead and put the link in the description of this video. So once you're here, you're going to see the option to go ahead and connect with the platform that you stream on. So I'm going to utilize YouTube. You can select Twitch. The process is the same. So once you go ahead and authenticate your channel with StreamElements, you then want to go ahead and come to the left-hand side and click on Alerts and Overlays. You're then going to select My overlays, and you're going to see here it says you don't have any overlays. So what you want to do is you want to select create new overlay, and once you do that, it's going to go ahead and ask you to select the resolution for your overlay. Go ahead and select 1080p and hit start. Then on the left hand side, what we want to do is you want to select add widget. We want to scroll down to engagement, and then we want to select countdown timer. Now you're going to see that this is where you're going to be able to customize the timer anytime you need to make adjustments. So the very first thing you're going to see here is you're going to see days, hours, minutes, seconds, and you can select this by an exact time or by an exact date. So let's say, for example, you wanted to do a date. You select the date, select the time, and then you're good to go. I personally utilize the count to exact time. And what I like to do is sometimes I put 5 minutes here, and you can set this to any time that you like. And then here at the bottom, I personally don't use days and hours, just minutes and seconds. So I simply just come here, delete that there. And then literally at the bottom, this is where it gives you the option to display a message once the countdown timer ends. Okay, you can leave it as countdown time is over. I'm gonna put let's dive in. It's something I say pretty often. And then you want to come down to position and sizing. Now, a good width and height, once again, you can customize this to your liking, but I found a sweet spot to be 400 by 150. And then what you want to do is you want to hit center widget. And then here on the bottom under text settings, this is where you're gonna be able to change the font, change the size, change the placement of it. So what I wanna do here, I'm fine with the font, and then I wanna go ahead and center it. So make sure that you center it there. And then as far as the color, I'm gonna go with a red. And you can see there that that's there, but now it's too small. So once again, you can change the size here, and I'm gonna go ahead and put that to about 60. Okay, that's about a good size there. And then that's pretty much it, right? So if this is all the changes that I wanted on my countdown timer, then that's pretty much all I want to go ahead and do. So I simply want to hit save. I'm going to go ahead and name this countdown. Okay, I'm going to hit save. And now the very next thing that we're going to do is you're going to come up to the top, you're going to copy this URL, and now you're going to go either to your Streamlabs or OBS. So for this, we'll be using OBS. And what you want to do is you want to come to your starting soon screen. You want to then hit the plus sign under sources. You then want to select browser, and then you want to go ahead and name this countdown timer. What you want to do now is you want to go ahead and paste that link that we just went ahead and copied, and you want to scroll down. And you want to go ahead and select where it says shut down source when not visible. Okay, now you hit okay, and now you're going to see here is the timer. So what we want to do is we want to scroll it up, we want to put it right where we want it. We can go ahead and lock the source. Now if you want to learn how to add overlays to OBS, go ahead and watch this video right here where I take you step by step on getting your overlay set up. I'll see you guys in the next video, and remember, together we all can thrive.